Hello everyone, welcome to India Defense Institute's Daily Current Affairs. So let us see some of the important current affairs of today. The first one is Exercise Peaceful Mission. Yes, recently the countries who are the members of Shanghai Cooperation Organization, SCO, they have conducted this joint counter-terrorism exercise which is named as Peaceful Mission. This exercise is conducted biennially, which means it happens every two years has been conducted. Yes, so this is the sixth edition of such exercise, and currently this exercise is hosted by Russia in this Orenburg region in the southwest Russia. Yes. And this will happen for more than a week. And what is the aim of this exercise? To increase the close relation and cooperation between the Shanghai Cooperation members, and also to enhance the military capacity and military ability of the countries. So this SCO, Shanghai Cooperation Organization, is seen as a counter to NATO. So NATO is North Atlantic Treaty Organization. It is a collective security organization of European countries, but this SCO is a counter to that, and it is a Eurasian economic, political and security organization. Yes, both India and Pakistan are members, so they both became members in 2017. Both India and Pakistan became members in 2017 in Astana meet in Kazakhstan. Yes, and this, as I told you, is intergovernmental organization founded on 2001. Yes, initially it is Shanghai 5. This organization is called Shanghai 5. Okay, to demilitarize the area after the disintegration of United Soviet Republic, USSR. Yes, but later it attained the characteristics of, you know, economic, political and security organization, Eurasian organization. Yes, as I told you, it includes 8 members: China, India, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Russia, Pakistan, Tajikistan, Uzbekistan. Yes, and the UK, there are also observer states including Afghanistan. Yes, so in BRIC countries, Russia, India and China, except Brazil and South Africa, all these 3 countries, they are part of this Shanghai Cooperation Organization. The second one is Kushinagar Airport. Yes, recently Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs, which is a department under this Tax Department, Ministry of Finance, okay, it has declared that the Kushinagar Airport and UP as a customs notified airport. Yes, it will facilitate international passenger movement, and also it will boost the tourism. Yes, the spiritual tourism, especially Buddhist tourism, because this place is very famous. This place is considered as the place where Buddha had died. Okay, so the death of Buddha in ancient India is called as Mahaparinirvana. Yes, where he attained moksha. Yes. Also in June 2020, this airport has been identified as international status to attract Buddhist pilgrims. Yes, spiritual tourism, and also it has become the third international airport in UP after Lucknow and Varanasi. So as of now, there are 3 international airports in UP: Lucknow, Varanasi and Kushinagar. Next one is Tarballs. Yes, recently, you know, in this Mumbai, along the west coast, specifically in Mumbai, they have collected nearly 20,000 kgs of tarballs in specifically Juhu and Versova beaches. Yes, so what are tarballs? It is in the name, tarballs. They are round, you know, round shaped balls, okay, which is dark colored sticky balls made of oil, specifically crude oil. Yes, so how it forms? Whenever the crude oil floats on the ocean surface, okay, the deep crude oil, whenever there is a crude oil discharge from the, you know, lowermost surface, bathymetric surface of the ocean, and also when there is oil spill by ships and all, so this crude oil, so oil and water, they don't mix together, and weathering of this crude oil in the marine environments, also this oil spill, it will make the crude to join together. Okay, and it is transported to the open sea by means of sea currents and waves. Gradually, it will be, you know, weighted along with the shore. It will be sent along to the shore. So this is called tarballs. So it looks as big as a basketball and also like small glues. You can see here. Yes. So it look like a tar. That is why it is called tarballs. Yes. So these tarballs are very difficult to wash up because it sticks to this. Okay, because it is made of oil and fat molecules. So why specifically it is been founded on the monsoon, in the sense, because we all know during this May to September, south west monsoon happens. So the direction of wind is like this, it goes like this. So this area below the Sri Lanka and below this Bay of Bengal area is very busiest area, Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal, because all the ships from the eastern side of the Asia, okay, it goes via this and it has to go to the Suez Canal. So this area is a very marine traffic area. So all the oil spills, everything, it is carried out to the coast by the influence of monsoon currents and monsoon waves. Yes. So due to the wind speed and direction, it is settled in the west coast of India, and this is considered as an environmental problem. Yes, and the oil spill in the Arabian Sea, it eventually get deposited in the western coasts in the form of tar balls. Yes, and this is a major environmental issue they are saying. The next is Shunya campaign. So recently in India and RMI India, okay, they both launched this Shunya campaign. So what is the campaign is all about? Simple, to promote zero pollution delivery vehicles, that is EV, electric vehicles, yes, for zero emission of carbon dioxide. Yes. So what is the meaning? Adoption of electric vehicles in the urban delivery segments, okay, and to also to create awareness among the people about the zero pollution delivery, because you all know the climate change and all the Paris climate deal, we have to limit the temperature for 1.5 degrees Celsius. So that is what India's, you know, nationally intended commitment by India. Okay, we have to limit the temperature by 1.5 degrees Celsius. Yes. And as a flip to give effect to it only, India has been recently, you know, creating lot of schemes to boost the electric vehicles in the economy. And one such scheme is FAME. Okay, it is under the Ministry of Heavy Industries. The main aim of the FAME scheme is to increase the production and selling of electric vehicles, and also to give subsidy to the production of electric vehicles. And this has happened phase 1 and phase 2. Currently, phase 2 is going on, this FAME scheme. Why? To increase the production and increase the usage of electric vehicles. Yes. So, as a part of this campaign, branding, certification of the program is launched, and also efforts to transition, okay, to transform from a typical conventional diesel petrol vehicle to electric vehicle has been put out. Yes. Next is Strotophodus jaisalmerensis. Yes. Recently in the Jaisalmer region of Rajasthan, the Geological Survey of India and the other officers there, they have found out oldest, you know, species, okay, fossil of oldest species called Hypodontshock, which belongs to this Jurassic age, okay, during that age where dinosaurs, okay, they have roamed around the earth. Yes. And this Hypodontshocks, it is reported for the first time from this Jurassic rocks. So the Jurassic period generally, okay, Jurassic, Triassic, Cretaceous period, in the Jurassic period is nearly 160 to 168 million years ago. So this Hypodonts are nothing but extinct group of sharks, okay, which is the previous version of, okay, the amphibians, but it is during the Jurassic period. You can see the teeth, this image. So this is how this fossil has been found out, and by carbon dating they have found it belonged to this Jurassic period. Yes. And this Hypodont shark, they started to decline in the marine environment during the middle Jurassic period. Yes. And then because amphibians started to come to land and they started to hover around the land, they became terrestrial animals. Yes. And they have discovered this crushing teeth. This is a crushing teeth from Jaisalmer, and since it has been found in the Jaisalmer, it is named as Jaisalmerensis. And this species has been included in the sharkreference.com, which is an international platform, okay, which is operating under IUCN. Shark references to get all the information about the sharks. The next one is reforms in the telecom sector. So recently, Union Cabinet has, you know, introduced lot of reforms, structural and process reforms in the telecom sector. So what is this? The first one is adjusted gross revenue, AGR. So recently, the Vodafone, Airtel, you know, and Idea, all these things, they were filed a case in the Supreme Court about AGR, adjusted gross revenue. How much amount? Okay, telecom operators generally auction the spectrum from the telecom sector, and then they have to pay the revenue back to the government as a share. Yes. And this AGR has accrued, and there is a small, you know, difference, and there is a small problem with the definition. So nearly 1.1 lakh crore has to be paid by the telecom operators. So the telecom operators wanted this amount to be, you know, excluded, okay, amount to be excluded, and they have filed a case in Supreme Court, but the Supreme Court clearly said that no, we have to pay the AGR dues. okay, and these companies have been lobbying to the government, asking them to at least give a reprieve. Okay, they have asked for 10 years period to pay it back. So it is kind of a debt. They are in a debt to the government. They have to pay this 1.1 lakh crore debt to the government. And recently, they also, you know, agreed to rationalize, to exclude this non-telecom revenues. So that only increased this to 1.1 lakh crore. And also, 4-year moratorium on telecom dues was also approved, which means they can pay after 4 years. Extension of debt period. Extension of debt. That is called as moratorium. Moratorium means temporary stay. Yes. As I told you, yes, they have, you know, defer the payment of up to 4 years, and they have to pay by means of net present value. And also, very importantly, nearly they have opened up the foreign direct investment, 100% FDI, under the automatic route in telecom sector. Before that, it is only 73%, 74%. It is now increased to 100% under automatic route. So there are two routes: government route for FDI to come to India, government route, and second one is automatic route. In government route, we have to go to the government department and they have to come. Whereas this automatic route, okay, we can directly go to RBI and then from then we can come and invest. So there is no need for permission from the government. That is called as automatic route. So automatic route makes the process very easy.
Yes.
And also spectrum usage charges have been rationalized.
Yes.
And the spectrum that year, auction year has been increased. Before that, the spectrum is auctioned to 20 years, but now it will be 30 years. So once you auction the spectrum for 30 years, you can use the specific spectrum. And also the KYC, know your customer norms, has been relaxed. So these are all the reforms in the telecom sector. Next is PLI scheme. PLI means production linked subsidy. Production linked subsidy, which means if you produce large, then you will be given subsidy. If you produce less, you will be given less subsidy. Produce more, you will be given more subsidy. So what is it? It is a kind of encouragement, okay? Encouragement to increase the production, automobile production.
Yes.
This will incentivize this high value advanced automotive technology vehicles and products.
Yes.
And it will attract also investments of to the tune of nearly 42,500 crores, and it will create an employment of nearly 7.5 lakh jobs.
Yes.
So industrial sector is developing, that too specifically Chennai is called as Detroit of South India, Detroit of Asia. And also Chennai is the automobile hub of India. You can see in Sribarambudur and Mahindra City and almost all of the producers, automobile producers, are there in Chennai only.
Yes.
And this scheme, okay, has specifically two components. One is Champion OEM. OEM means Original Equipment Manufacturer Scheme, and Component Champion Incentive Scheme. So this Champion OEM incentive scheme is applicable to battery electric vehicles and hydrogen fuel vehicles. And this Component Champion Incentive Scheme, it is related to, you know, advanced automotive technology components for two-wheelers, three-wheelers and all the other passenger vehicles. So this will boost the automobile sector, which has been, you know, under heavy, okay, reprieve and under heavy, you know, damage because of this recent pandemic issue. Next is transparent ceramics. So Indian researchers have recently developed a transparent ceramics, okay, which is a ceramic. Generally ceramic, it is a opaque material, so the, you know, ceramic has been made transparent. Why? In the sense, it can be used in a thermal imaging operation, because glasses, which is transparent, it won't stand the high heat and other conditions, okay, high thermal condition, other conditions. So this ceramic will be strong than the glass, and also it can be used as helmets, protection helmets and other equipments like goggles and shield, all other things.
Yes.
So this is a new class of advanced material with a good transparency and excellent mechanical properties.
Yes.
And this, they say that this transparent ceramics can also be used, you know, for transparent light and also for UV, infrared and also radio frequency for diverse application, mostly in defense and defense related technologies.
Yes.
And as I told you, it is for strategic application like in infantry, protectional, you know, equipments, thermal imaging, thermal scanning, because the glass won't stand the heat, rather ceramic, it will withstand the heat. That is why even in houses and all, the handles of all the utensils and all, it is used to be in the ceramic. So that's it with today's current affairs. So let us come up with more informative and innovative current affairs tomorrow. Okay, the link is there to attend the quiz. After this video, you can go and attend the link which is given in the description. Thank you.